Item 9, request by 14905 Hopewell Group, LLC, to amend zoning conditions placed on ZA2457. Mr. Brown.
AZ130016, located in Commission District Number 3. The public hearing is for 14905 Hopewell Group, LLC, regarding the amendment of condition number 4 placed on zoning application 2457. The applicant requests that condition number 4 be amended to read as shown on your screen. The property is located on the east side of Bethelview Road at the end of Bennett Parkway. It was zoned CBD and R3 by the R3 with a PUD overlay by the Board of Commissioners on November 13th, 2000.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Is there a motion to open a public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
Motion second to open a public hearing. Please vote. Motion carries 5-0. Is anyone here this evening like speak in favor of Hopewell Group?
Mr. Chairman, members of the Board of Commissioners, Emory Lipscomb here on behalf of this request to amend this condition number 4, which currently reads there shall be no more than 324 single-family homes. The current density is based on the development of commercial commingled with single-family residential homes. Current zoning allows 282,000 square feet of commercial area and 300 parking spaces, and we are requesting to amend that to add 61 single-family residences. The parking and the traffic would result in at least 50% more traffic to this development if it was developed as it's currently zoned than will be the case with the addition of 61 homes, and that could be as high as four times as great. So It would depend on the type of commercial uses that were put on the property, but it would be at least 50% greater traffic and perhaps as much as 400% additional traffic on the road there. I'll be glad to answer any questions. These homes will be like those that exist in the residential portion of this property, and they'll be comparable in price and in size. Thank you.
Mr. Listen, are we deleting all the commercial along for this section?
Yes. Okay. This is a deletion of the commercial. This is a residential subdivision that's there, and the commercial, to put commercial on that street that goes to these residences, we think would not be as compatible as putting more residential to the same type, same size lots, basically, is what is currently there.
What's the actual density you're asking for? I know it's a res 4, but what will be the density per acre?
If it was a res 4.
The way you're asking for this to change to take place?
Well, a res 4 would allow, of course, four units to the acre.
You're wanting to add
61
new lots.
Yes, sir.
And over how many acres of land that was CBD?
Help me with that.
That's
17. So it'd be about, that'd be a little less than 4 to the acre.
So
the neighborhood that's adjacent to it that you're wanting to make like kind, if you will, on the lot sizes and such. And you have it here as a 1,400 square foot minimum on these. Is that the same as adjacent neighborhood?
I think that'd be the minimum, but I don't think the houses would be that small.
What do you suppose? Well, we'll talk to some other folks. I bet some other folks will come up and we'll have some more discussion, but I'd like to make it, if it's going to be like kind, let's try to make
That's
it
fine.
More like
yes,
kind.
Sir. Yes, sir. That's the intent, that it would
does
be like kind.
Does the original zoning have bill of materials stated and things like that, Todd?
I know our codes today have changed over they were in the past, especially when it comes to building materials for fire code and such when the homes are closer than at 20 feet. So we'll need to make sure all this in here as well if we choose to approve it.
Any other questions? Thank you, Mr. Lipscomb.
Thank you.
Would anyone else like to speak in favor? I see a hand. Favor? Would anyone like to speak in opposition? Please come forward and be respectful. We have 10 minutes. That's about five of y'all.
My name is Brian Long. I'm a homeowner. Actually, I live right on Bennett Parkway. My front yard looks into this acreage, and I'm glad they're going to clean it up. The problem is, you guys may not be aware of, there's been two fires in this neighborhood, and they're proposing almost 700 homes worth of cars to drive down this road. On two occasions, people couldn't get in or out of this neighborhood because there's going to be only one entrance because of the fire trucks. The first fire destroyed four homes on the top. The second one was a car fire on the main street. So I'm opposed to a changing. It is what it is now. It's zoned with the commercial. Like you said, it's going to be, he doesn't know how many more cars are going to be going through this, up to 400% more cars with the zoning change. So I'm completely against it just because of the number of cars and the past experience that the neighbors have felt, the neighborhood has felt from the fires and the street closures. 3 hours people couldn't get in and out. What if there's an emergency? A couple times there's been five or six fire trucks blocking the roads, and the roads are already narrow enough, cars can't pass the fire trucks.
The homes you're referring to on Quantum Fire, did they have vinyl siding on them or cementous material?
The neighborhood, it has both. So the top portion of the neighborhood is vinyl. The bottom is hardy plank.
And the ones that were on fire, were they the ones that were vinyl?
I believe so, yes.
And the county doesn't even allow that. Just let you know, we don't allow that anymore in the county. You can't do vinyl anymore.
No, that's fine, but okay. There was a car fire on the main entrance.
Okay.
And you can't prevent cars being, I mean.
The car wasn't vinyl, apparently.
I know, I understand. I just want to know that, in case you have a feeling that the house is in four of them caught on fire in a row, and were those the vinyl ones that four caught on fire? And
no, it's just, it's a, he doesn't know the traffic. How much more traffic is this going to put onto this street?
Yeah, I agree with you.
Let's let everybody
speak. Okay.
And there's, the existing okay. homes are not 1,400 square feet. They're much larger than that.
That's what I wanted to know. Thank you.
Commissioners, my name is Deborah Foote, and I live at property that adjoins the property, the 17.5 acres in question. I've been there for over 10 years, and I've looked very carefully at this, and the thing that also concerns me is this property comes off of Bennett Parkway. Bennett Parkway is the only entrance in and out for the existing 324 homes. Half of that community is retirement. The other half, closer to Bethelview Parkway, is family-oriented. We have traffic that is unbelievable on that road. We have school buses, and we have no sidewalks. The other thing that I would mention to you is we have no ordinance there, because it's an unincorporated county, that restricts people from parking on the road, which they currently do. It is not against the law. I can't even tell you how many near misses involving children that we've had on that road. I looked at the proposed ordinance for the development, and I have one question for Mr. Lipscomb. When he mentioned a 400% traffic increase, is that if the property were left commercial, or what does he know what the percentage of traffic impact would be if it were zoned for 61 more houses. And one other thing he didn't mention in the proposal package is not only 61 more houses, but 16 townhomes in addition to that. I'd like to know what the impact of traffic would be if it is rezoned to incorporate those 16 townhomes and those other 61 homes. I don't foresee anything but a tragedy. I lived in the community at the time that those fires happened. In fact, they happened on the street that I lived, and those four homes burned in 13 minutes to the ground. The homes that are being proposed here are similar to the homes that we have in the respect of the land between them. There's very little yard, you might say, regardless of front and back space. What I'm talking about is they're very close together. And that's another concern, again, with the amount of traffic. The other question that I have, and I don't know if it's proper to wait for the answer to that, do you have that impact on the traffic if it were zoned residential? Should I wait for an answer? Or?
Well, here, give us some answers. We can ask him those questions when he stands back up.
Okay.
We'll go through it.
The other thing that I know that property went into foreclosure at one point, and that it is now being requested by, at least on the application, a company called Equity Trust. I don't know who Equity Trust is. I know that Equity Trust is not listed on the deed in the county as the owner of that property. Is that a normal way that business is conducted in Forsyth? I would think that the owner would have to be the one to proffer a request for rezoning. The application is made by, it's listed as the owner as Equity Trust. Equity Trust is not listed on the deed currently. Maybe it's not recorded yet. But again, I would reiterate my concerns are because of the traffic. And I think that putting 61 additional homes and 16 townhomes on Bennett Parkway, and if you look back, you'll see what I'm talking about. The proposed roads that would go in there by this development are again opening on to Bennett Parkway. There is no other way. That's my concern, and thank you for hearing me.
Thank you, ma'am.
What is this?
Jody, turn around.
It allows the slides to be changed on the display, okay. Sir.
My name's Joe Smith again. I'm here. I live in that neighborhood, and I can tell you several things. What she described, that stoplight, when we come out, we all have only one choice at Bennett Parkway to get out of that subdivision. And I've pulled up there and waited 3 or 4 minutes just for the light to change. But there's always a line there, and most people want to turn left going toward 400, and it's horrendous already. So my point would be, I'm kind of a little bit in favor of getting rid of the commercial part of this, but I'm really against the number of houses they want to put in there. Because the volume of people that will generate and the number of cars is, I'd like to see some study that they would provide to show how that would work out. I think he's clearly underestimating the impact this would have on our neighborhood and the neighborhood that he's proposing to put in there. So when you add that many houses, plus, if I understood it right, I'd like to hear him address it. I thought they were talking about putting those houses 10 feet apart. And I'd be interested to hear if that's true. If it is, that's really not good at all. And I have a similar concern about who's the owner? Who's really trying to accomplish this? My second question about whoever that is, how long have they been in business? You know, what kind of, do you guys know what kind of a quality organization they are? So thank you for our considerations. Please don't let this pass today.
Thank you, sir.
Good evening. My name is Nydia Tisdale. I live in Roswell, and I'm a proofreader and a fact checker. And what caught my eye on the site plan tonight is the seal in the bottom right-hand side, and the name is Contracting Engineers Incorporated. To my knowledge, that company is not registered with the state as required by the Unified Development Code, as required by Georgia Code. And in Chapter 8, Zoning and Application Procedures Section, or Chapter 1, your site plan minimum requirements require that a site plan be prepared by registered land surveyor, engineer, etc. To my knowledge, this has not been done. Thank you. I would recommend that you delay any action or just deny the site plan as presented tonight because it does not meet the requirements of your Unified Development Code. Thank you.
I see someone else. Yes, sir.
Bob Rausch again. You're going to hear the same story. He's asking for Res 4, and he's putting 61 homes plus townhomes. Why don't you tell him to go back and make it Res 2 or Res 3 and come back here with a plan that will actually more fit with the neighborhood, the traffic, and everything else.
Thank you, sir. Anyone else like to speak in opposition? Yes, ma'am.
I would just like to point out.
Just give us your name, please.
Oh, I'm sorry. Joan Rusek. I would just like to point out that Atlanta Gas just put a huge gas line through that property, has an easement on it. They want to build homes right next to that. And they have a pumping station there because they've increased the gas going towards 400. And I wouldn't want to buy a house on top of a gas line if that were me. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Anyone else want to speak in opposition? Mr. Lipscomb, I believe you have some questions to answer.
Thank you. This property is zoned PUD. The residential component of this property is developed to at least the density that we're talking about for these residences. The 61 residences that would be located on this property would produce 670 trips a day. If the full development of the commercial, which is approved for this property, took place, it would produce 2,900 trips a day for that full development of this property. Now, it could be less than that. It could be as much less as 900 and some odd trips a day. But that would be half, again, as much traffic as the 61 homes would produce. The homes will run from $240,000 up. That's the estimated cost of the homes. And they'll be comparable to those that are there now. So what you're doing, if you approve this, you're matching the homes that are there now.
One question about, you're talking about the 61 homes. What did the 16 townhomes come in? Are you just asking for 61 additional lots?
That's the total number, is 61. Along the what I would call the western boundary of this property, along the commercial that currently exists along Bethelview Road, you'll see those 16 units. As you go in Bennett Parkway, immediately on the right, you'll see those units. They back up directly against the existing commercial, and they are the smaller homes that are proposed there. The smaller lots that are proposed there.
Are these townhomes?
They are. Well, I don't know that they're. They're narrow lots. There's an example of the two types of product in the package of information, and it shows those as being a smaller product there.
But it's only 61 total lots.
Total of 61.
So it's not 61 plus 16.
No, sir. That's correct.
It's only 61.
That's correct. Thank you.
Right now, the way I'm reading this is it's approved for an estimated 282,000 square feet of commercial with 300 parking places.
That's correct.
If each one of those parking places realistically turned over just four times, that's 1,200.
That's right.
61 homes, if they had four trips a day or more or less, somebody...
A little over 10 trips a day is where we come up with the 670.
That's 10 trips a day. And of course, I'd ask the folks that live in your house how many people live there, how many trips a day y'all making out of your house compared to what 300 parking places will equate to if it was stayed commercial. Is there any way that we could allow the opposition, now that this more information is coming out, if they want to make any additional comments, Mr. Chairman? I'd still like to hear a little more from them.
You can ask questions. You can ask them questions, can't you, Counselor?
ask questions, or you could extend the time for public comment. It's up to you.
That's what I'm asking for. Well, I'd really like to extend the time, but I'd also like to let them understand that I believe that Mr. Lipscomb's and his facts and the numbers showing here that if it stays as is commercial, you will have a lot more trip charges of cars and a lot more traffic if it stays as is. And if you disagree, I'd still like to hear from you and how you see it different. I'm trying to add this up before I make a decision.
To extend the time, maybe 5 minutes to opposition?
I second that.
Is that a... As, okay. We'll so, extend the time.
So that was without exception, or you can take a vote on that?
By exception.
Without exception. Okay.
No exception.
No exception. Yes, sir.
Brian Long, I live in the community. There's no way there's going to be that many cars going in and out. The commercial space would be not desirable. I mean, there's three or four prime areas around that, across the street from it, near it, that aren't even, you could do a survey. They're not even going in or using those parking spots. There's no way. It's all about the narrowness of the streets and the capacity that those streets can have. They can't support 10 more cars in that neighborhood. You're just waiting for, the zoning is what it is now. I'd rather play and deal with the commercial land, the aspect that that traffic is going to be different than the neighborhood traffic at that light. Don't approve it. It's leave it how it is.
When you give him another second, I'm still interested in the answer to my question. Does any part of his plan include a distance of 10 feet between houses? I have that question. But the other comment that I'd make is we were talking about he said his numbers were based on 10 trips a day for each house. I don't know how many of all of us make 10 trips in and out every day from our house.
Then he's high. Then he would be way high on the house.
Yes, he's way high with that estimate.
On the residential.
Yes.
So the commercial you believe would produce a lot more than the residential he's proposing.
Right. I'm not, as I mentioned the first time, I'm not against much. I'm there not very much against residential. I don't like the idea of commercial, but the number of houses is way too high. That ought to be reduced, and it can be reduced. You know, if they want to put in houses, bring in some number that's reasonable. But is it 10 feet between some houses? I think that's horrendous given the fires that I observed. I was there that day. So when he gets a chance, I'd like to see him answer a couple of those questions.
I'd also like to comment on the townhouses. As the first gentleman that spoke, the townhouses are proposed. One thing Mr. Lipscomb said is that the townhouses back Bethelview. They don't. They back the commercial properties that are already on Bethelview. There is no entrance or exit to Bethelview from the front of this property for those townhouses to use. They too would have to have an opening onto Bennett Parkway. They might be inclusive in the number count of 61. I'm not sure of that, but they are 16 separate units proposed as townhomes. That's my clarification.
Thank you, ma'am. Mr. Lipscomb, do you have a, are you, what's the distance between these houses or proposed?
I'm sorry.
What's the distance between houses?
Distance between the houses. It's shown, again, it's shown on the plan, and it is the same as what exists for the homes which are there. I believe it's 10 feet between the houses. I believe that's correct.
It matches what's currently there, doesn't it? Hmm. The houses are currently 10 foot apart.
I believe that's correct. The ones that are.
No, that's incorrect.
Well.
Emory, can you address the issue about the application name versus the actual owner of the property? That was asked by one of the gentlemen, I think.
I'm sorry, Jim.
There was an issue that one of the gentlemen had about who owns the property versus whose name is on the zoning application.
That was the first I've heard of that. I haven't looked into that. I'd be glad to look into it and try to answer the question. I don't know.
And whoever asked that question, can you, wasn't you asked? No.
No, it was just
whoever it was. Could they come and refresh us about what the question was, please, in case I got it wrong?
Well, I think the fact check lady over
Sir.
The application for the rezoning request made by the company, help me out with the name of it, is it Falling Waters? That application, if you look at the application itself, there's a place on there that lists the owner of the property. That is listed, that is the property as listed as Equity Trust. Equity Trust happens to be property transferred by a gentleman named Danny Bennett to Equity Trust in the form of two IRAs, one at 50% and one at 25%. Is it Equity Trust that is currently making the request for this zoning change? Is it Three Rivers? Is it the company Hopewell Group, which is not even licensed as an LLC yet here in Forsyth County? I mean, how do these things get to the point of coming before you for a rezoning when it is not clearly deeded who the property belongs to and who's making the request? Those are the questions that I had asked.
Counselor, I think a couple of questions are going to come your way.
Mr. Chairman, if I might address that question. I'm Josh Scoggins with Emory's office. The applicant does not have to be the same as the property owner. That's why we submit property owner authorization forms. But with respect to the ownership of the property, that question was raised by the county. And we have submitted a deed to the county evidencing the conveyance to the property owner mentioned in the application. So I think that should address that question.
Do you have a question?
I do. In reference to Ms. Tisdale's comments about the, we've once heard before about the stamps at this stage of the game and the shall and the et cetera, would you please elaborate on that? And does it have to have the engineer or the survey stamp at this point in time, or does it have to have it once it passes this stage?
Well, I think the application has to be complete for a zoning application, but I did discuss this with Mr. Brown, and I believe the takeaway that I heard was that because this is a zoning condition amendment, there's not a requirement for your typical zoning site plan at all. Am I getting that right, Tom?
Yes, depending on the content of the request, and to respond to Commissioner Levent's questioning, the word ETC, et cetera, is in there, and my response to the board is, I think if we want this to be a higher standard, if we want to see a stamped professional licensed with the state always stamping and signing these documents, we need to make an edit to our code to require that. It doesn't require that today. It comes short of that. It makes some suggestions, but it ends the sentence with et cetera and leaves a little bit of a wild card there.
So it does not actually require it the way our UDC is written today. And Counselor, would you concur?
I will concur that et cetera provides discretion with respect to how that is to be interpreted. And I believe that the director is comfortable interpreting how he has interpreted it. So yes, I do think I think that does vest in him discretion to make the call as to what et cetera means.
It doesn't have to have those stamps that are from an engineer or a survey at this point.
Well,
if it passes zoning, then it does.
A couple of thoughts. I think it has to have some stamp on it, because even though it says et cetera, it still is putting a mandatory obligation for there to be some certification on this document. Presumably, it would be from someone that has an expertise in preparing site plans of that kind. And I understood that one of the issues was the viability of that entity being a legitimate issue. Forget about whether it's an engineer or not. I thought it was whether it's in fact a bona fide corporation or not. And in that respect, I'm not able to answer that, although I have heard from another prior zoning that was in fact an issue. I believe in the other one, I believe, Commissioner Levent, you may have made a motion on that particular issue. To me, when the takeaway I had with respect to this one as to why we could proceed, though, was that a site plan of the nature that accompanies a brand new rezoning was not required, because this was simply a condition amendment.
Commissioner Lynn, I believe we had like 1 minute left on the opposition before the time ran out. We had Mr. Lipscomb was up. Would you like to come forward, sir? You had 1 minute. Come to the podium.
Put the stamp up, would you please?
She's right. I mean, you cannot purport to be a surveyor, engineer, stamp drawings or anything in the state of Georgia if you're not a licensed, registered either PE or surveyor, because I am licensed.
We understand that.
And I don't know how anybody can submit a drawing to a public agency, and this is rezoning, without a legitimate stamp.
Our UDC is what I was trying to clear up, is whether or not it requires it in this case to be one of those two items. That's what my question was.
Mr. Durkin said left. There's so many issues with this, even legal issues. It seems to me like minimally you'd have to put this off until a whole lot more information is known and we can speak about facts. We should not, in my neighborhood, we shouldn't be jeopardizing our situation. And I thought I heard you say that this question had come up sometime before, and it sounded like it was resolved to stop. So anyway, I don't know how we could go forward.
Thanks, sir. Is there a motion? Let's go ahead. Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
Please vote. Motion carries 5-0. Any other discussion among the commissioners? Any questions at this time? Commission District 3, Commissioner Levent.
What I'm pondering right now, fellow commissioners, is a reset, but what is a reasonable reset? And if so, what would be the full reason of the reset and the motion? Mr. Gerard, do you suppose they could get this together, or Mr. Brown, if we just do a 2-week reset? I know I'm not worried about the stamp. I think that's been clearly conveyed by both you as a director and counselor that that's not required the way our UDC is written today.
What do you need clarity on, Commissioner Levent? I mean, what you said, a 2-week postponement?
That's what I'm thinking.
For what
and
reason?
And I'm trying to give you a full reason. I mean, you've heard everybody's comments and their concerns. The question is, and I've also written down some of those concerns, is if we do make a motion to approve it today, I do believe at the bare minimum we should add a square foot minimum to these homes, which I didn't get any kind of clarification from anybody yet what they believe their neighbor next door is. Then I also believe that we should consider making the homes at least 15 feet apart and let the UDC fire code apply, which is some interest materials that are fire retardant or resistant, however it's worded. In addition to that, none of the houses should be closer to the 7 feet to the property line with an overall 15 feet. And I still, and possibly a reduction of the overall product, if they want to do this 16 townhome, so be it. But the overall, maybe we would consider reducing it to maybe 55 units or something. But until we have a little more clarification, I'm just not sure we shouldn't postpone this for a little more clarification and discussion to come up with something a little more solid that's more palatable for everybody.
You gave some viable reasons for postponement. That's all I was asking for.
All right, thank you.
Commissioner Levent, just as far as I'm concerned, I've heard a lot of legal issues been raised as well. I don't know if they are viable legal issues or not, but they have been raised, and I'm not sure that I'm comfortable addressing every one of them on the fly tonight, including the issue of the stamp in the context of a zoning condition amendment. I would prefer, you know, if you're going to give some time, that would be fine. I can do what I need to do in 2 weeks.
So August 15th, Councilor, or Commissioner Levent?
Yes, I'll make a motion. We postpone this to the August 15th meeting, and thank you, Councilor.
Second.
I have a motion and a second for postponement to August 15th. Please vote. Motion carries 5-0. And that will be for a motion only, no public hearing. Public hearing has been closed. Thank y'all.